My name is Ariella. So I'd like to thank my mentor, Dr. Bishakha. So Dr. Bishakha is from India. She came to the United States to do research. She has her PhD in neuroscience from UT Southwestern, and her hobbies include dancing and reading, amongst others. Okay, my magical experience. So the highlights of my experience have been to be able to choose my own topic to learn and research it independently, and then if I don't understand something, I'm able to ask for help from my mentor, which has been very helpful. And I've learned how to research a topic in depth. Like, sometimes it's hard to see where to start, because starting out I didn't know really anything about this topic, so it was just a very developmental experience for me, and I really enjoyed it. Okay, so my project is on antibiotic resistance, so it's a scientific research experiment. So why I chose this project. So antibiotics save millions of lives every year, and they've become such a part of our daily lives. Well, not daily, but whenever we get sick, we can rely on our doctors to give us antibiotics and to make us feel better. But antibiotic resistance means that in the near future, these antibiotics could stop working. And that's something that definitely has to be addressed and definitely has to be researched about. Okay, so just to show how pressing of an issue this is, here's some recent news about antibiotic resistance. And here is a map showing the different death caused by antibiotic-resistant bacteria worldwide, all across the world. See, in India, the European Union, Thailand, United States. And one of the many causes of antibiotic resistance is the overprescription of antibiotics. Because when you overprescribe antibiotics, that means more bacteria are being exposed to these antibiotics and can therefore develop mutations and become immune. So here, just to show the severity of that issue, is a chart showing the amount of overprescription of antibiotics in the United States. So in order to understand antibiotic-resistant bacteria, first you have to understand bacteria. So bacteria are all around us. There are 5 million trillion bacteria in the world, which is a lot. And some of them are good for us, and some of them we need. Some of them are even inside our bodies. But there are also bacteria that can cause infections, such as these, and some of these infections could be fatal. So what antibiotics do is antibiotics fight these harmful bacteria, and they save millions of lives in the process. So there's different types of antibiotics. So there's bacteriostatic antibiotics. So what those do is they interfere with the life processes of the bacteria, causing them to die out more slowly. Then there's bactericidal antibiotics. So what those do is they attack the cell wall of the bacteria, causing it to explode and die more immediately. And then you have broad spectrum antibiotics. So those can target many different types of bacteria, and targeted can only attack a very specific few. So here's some main types of antibiotics that are prescribed very regularly. So we have penicillin, which was the first antibiotic, and it's broad spectrum and bactericidal. We have ampicillin, which is one of the most commonly prescribed, and it's also bactericidal broad spectrum. So there's also amoxicillin, which is the other one that's most commonly prescribed, and it is also bactericidal and broad spectrum. And there's azithromycin, which is also broad spectrum, but as opposed to the other ones, this one's bacteriostatic. So antibiotics have saved an estimated 200 million lives since the discovery of penicillin. And just to give some perspective, 5 out of every 6 people in the United States are going to be prescribed antibiotics in the year. So that's 269.4 million antibiotics were prescribed in the United States. So as we said, penicillin was the first of the antibiotics. So just to show how groundbreaking that discovery was, here's some news articles from that time. So, due to technical difficulties, we were unable to conduct the experiment, but the plan was to test the effect of different concentrations of bactericidal and bacteriostatic antibiotics on local cultures of bacteria. So, a Harvard study actually did a very similar experiment. Can I show it on the board? Will it work? So, how it works was, on the outside of these plates, there was no antibiotics, so as you see, the bacteria, which is the white, grew, filled the entire plate pretty much immediately. And then as you go inside the plate, there is a higher concentration of antibiotics, increasing as you go closer to the inside. And in a period of 5 to 6 days, the entire plate was completely covered with bacteria that had become resistant to the antibiotic over time. So this is a graph showing the results. So at a low concentration of antibiotics, it's very easy for bacteria to survive and therefore develop mutations, and they evolve much more quickly. But as the concentration gets higher, as you see, the slope goes down, but they're still able to evolve until they reach a point where this dotted line is, where no matter how much antibiotics you add, they're not going to be killed out. So this shows, just as an example, the importance of taking all of your dosage of antibiotics. If your doctor prescribes you 10 days of antibiotics and you only take 8 of those days, your body is in a high enough concentration to kill off all the antibiotics, and you're causing some of them to become resistant. Thank you so much.